Welcome back, guys. So today I want to talk about rebound relationships. Now, many of us, probably all of us, have been a part of a rebound relationship in one way or another. And rebound relationships are generally that person who feel or probably were the cause of the relationship to fail. Now, it could have failed because you did some, ungodly act in a relationship, or you were not fulfilling your partner's desires, whatever the case may be. So you tend to immediately find a mate for whatever reason. Now, those two reasons are generally positive and negative. Positively, if you've just recently gotten out of a relationship, and you are seeking a mate, it could be because you actually miss what a long-term relationship entails, hugging, kissing, dates, and things like that. So you abruptly find someone to fill that void. And upon doing so, if you were that person in the relationship, per se, there could be many reasons why the relationship failed and who's to blame, whatever. But for example, you were unfulfilling in your relationship. At least that's what the partner told you. So now you feel as though you need to get into this new relationship, and it could feel rushed. You may rush the partner or the potential partner by overcompensating and trying to fulfill, the partner's needs, or just being too available because you don't want to fail again. So as this rebound partner, it's like you're taking them through something. Like, you want them to be your change. If that makes sense. It's like you're trying to convince yourself. You're trying to prove your self-worth in a relationship so that you're no longer to blame. So you unintentionally have an effect on this new relationship, and it may be moving so fast. You guys may still be in the dating stage, whereas you're still in relationship mode. So you're trying to do everything to pull out all the stops. You're trying to, call too many times a day, or being too affectionate, and just it can be annoying. It can have an adverse effect of what you're really trying to do. So this new rebound relationship may just backfire because you have not given yourself time to process what just happened in your last relationship, grow from it, and move on effectively. Okay, there's no sense of moving on if you're just going to wreak havoc in yet another situation. That's just senseless. And this happens all the time. People jump from one relationship to another trying to prove themselves worthy of being in a relationship, whereas it's like you're stumbling over your own self trying to correct a past situation. That's senseless. Take time, heal, find your flaws, and then just deal with it. Find someone who's willing to do that. Okay, now, in a negative sense, the negative aspect, this rebound may be for malintent. Perhaps you were the one who were heartbroken. And so now you feel as though you need to, I mean, you are in a sense missing being in a relationship. So you're gonna find the first thing smoking. Okay, especially someone who's more vulnerable because it's going to work for your benefit. And with this person, you'll find yourself deflecting, just rebelling for no reason. If he or she asks you to call, you don't call. You call maybe hours later, or may not show up until the next day. You purposely hurt this person because you want this person to feel what it is that you're feeling. And this type of rebound typically does not talk about their ex or their past relationship. It's because they're on a mission, okay? And that mission is to cause havoc. You want someone to feel your pain. So you're going to do whatever it is to cause that, you know, disappointment, just headaches, whatever it is. You're going to make sure you execute. And you're probably good at it because this happens all the time, these type of rebound relationships. And this person may never commit to you. If you feel as though this person seems like they're holding off, like there's something that's keeping them from opening up to you, well, this could be the reason, especially if they have mentioned that they were just recently in a relationship, then that could be why. They may still actually be in love. I mean, you're going to always love a person, but they may still be holding on to that past love. And they're not going to ever give that away. If they do, it's going to take a lot to break that person to get back to where they once were. Until then, it's rebound mode. You know, every person after that is going to be rebound until they get over it, until they feel, you know, as though they've accomplished what it is that they were seeking, you know, it was punishment enough. So yeah, that's like the worst type of rebound there is. So just be mindful if you are trying to do a rebound. You know, it's really not worth it to go into someone else's life and waste their time if you're not going to be serious and genuine because you're heartbroken or you're feeling some kind of way or whatever, and you want to deflect that pain upon that person. It's just senseless and it's immature. Okay. So yeah, that is all for a rebound relationship. I thank you guys so much for joining me today. And be sure to comment. If you have a topic that you would like for me to speak about it, list it or send me an email or something. Let me know what it is that you would like for me to do a video about it. I'll be glad to do it. Okay. That's my time, guys. I thank you so much for joining me. And until next time, take care.